We want to multiply the following monomials. Here we have 7 times 5k. Well, remember, 5k means 5 times k. So these are all connected by multiplication. So if we wanted to, we could write this as 7 times 5 times k, which is equal to 35k. Looking at the second example, we have negative 3x times 9y. And again, negative 3x means negative 3 times x, and 9y means 9 times y. And because everything is connected by multiplication, we could change the order without changing the product. This is the commutative property of multiplication. So we could write this as negative 3 times 9 times x times y, if that helps. And we can see the result would be negative 27xy. And the same thing is true for the third example. 2x squared means 2 times x squared times 3x to the fourth, which means 3 times x to the fourth. And so we can change the order of this multiplication. We would have 2 times 3 times x to the second times x to the fourth. So we have 6. And then for x to the second times x to the fourth, since the bases are the same and we're multiplying, we'll add the exponents. So we'd have x to the sixth. I know after you do these a while, you probably won't take this extra step and change the order of the multiplication, but when first learning, this might be helpful. For this last example, we have x to the second all over 4 raised to the third power. There's a couple ways of doing this. We could just expand this and write 3 factors of x to the second over 4, but we could also apply this rule here that says if we have powers to powers, we multiply the exponents. We do need to recognize that this would be 4 to the first. And then if we multiply the exponents, we would have x to the power of 2 times 3, that's 6. And we'd have 4 to the power of 1 times 3, that's 4 to the third. We can evaluate the denominator. We have x to the 6 over 4 to the third, which is 64. And just to show the alternative here, we could have written out 3 factors of x to the second over 4. That's what it means to have something raised to the third power. And then from here, looking at the numerator, x to the second times x to the second times x to the second would have given us x to the sixth. And 4 times 4 times 4, of course, is equal to 64. So the result is the same, even though our approach was different. I hope this was helpful.